Hi, in this section I'd like to talk about DPA administration, adding a PowerProtect DD using the data collection wizard. So obviously to add a PowerProtect DD or DDVE using the DPA's discovery wizard, the discovery wizard will automatically assign and configure the agent request for data collection from the PowerProtect DD or DDVE. Note that DPA uses both SNMP and SSH type requests or protocols to collect data from the PowerProtect DD. You will need to use the DD system manager to create a PowerProtect DD username password with a user role. And if you want to use the data domain analysis request and or the DD physical capacity SSH request, you will also require a PowerProtect DD username password with an admin role and a PowerProtect DD username password with security role if you're using the later versions of DDoS. You will also need to set up an SNMP read-only community string on the data domain. So let's first have a look at the data domain DD system manager. You'll see in the local user, I've created a DPA admin with admin role, DPA security with security role, and a DPA user with user role. Under settings, SNMP, I've set up a version 2C community string called public, and to make it more secure, I've added in the hosts. That is the DPA agent host IP address that will be doing the data collection from the DD. Okay. With that set, let's go to the DPA UI, call up the discovery wizard. And let's add in the data domain. Right, I'm going to add in one data domain. If you have multiple, you can use a CSV file. That's my data domain. And obviously you can't install a DPA agent on the PowerProtect DD, so you need to select a remote data collection agent. It's defaulted to the DPA agent on the application server. So because this is a lab system and demo, I can do it, but in a production system, it is advised that you use a DPA agent that is closest to the data domain, that is in the same network, same data center, etc., right? The DPA agent can multitask. So if you have a network or server in London with an agent on that network or server, that agent can also be set up to collect the data domain's data in the same data center closest to that network or server, right? That kind of idea. The SNMP credentials. Select credentials. So I pre-created them and I called it DD SNMP. Then select the SSH credential, which is the DPA user. Select the SSH PCR credential, which is the admin, and the security role. Okay. So as always, go to credentials and create these first before you go to the discovery wizard. Hit next, I will start the test. Test successful. Next. Usual prompts of where you want to put it in the scope, any attributes that you want to modify, and done. Okay. As always, to check, you can go to Object Library. This time we go to the Storage tab, and that's where you'll see the DD object, data collection, and there you can see all the various data domain requests auto-assigned, right? So you will see the requests that use SSH will have SSH in its name. If it doesn't, it's probably using SNMP. You can also tell by the credential type, right? Do note that the data domain analysis request by default is set to manual. Not everyone wants this type of data. If you do want it, it is available for you to set on a schedule. So you can run it on a period, on a schedule, or leave it at manual, right? And for schedule, you can go here and say 9 a.m. every day, right? Or if you don't want that, you want a different period, you can go to schedules, create another one, and put it in there, right? The reason why it is manual is because the data domain analysis request does an SFS dump, which is a very expensive operation on the data domain itself. So we do not recommend that you run this more than once in a 24-hour period, like once a day. By rule of thumb, I would suggest maybe run it once a week during a weekday when the data domain is least used. So for example, a Monday lunchtime, right? So bear those in mind. The data domain analysis request does SFS dumps of each of the DD entries, and it correlates it back to the job data that's already in the DPA data store and pumps the results back into DPA, right? This request is used to help scenarios where your data domain has hit 80% full and you want to try and find out who the culprit is. There are other reports that are populated as well as a byproduct of this function, but it is an extremely helpful function as well. Okay. So, now that is done, oh yes, let's have a look and check that the SNMP request ran, and there you can see it was successful. Let's check an SSH request, for example, this performance one, it was successful. Right, and because we have Avamar job data in the system already that's writing to this actual data domain, we can kick this off. It will prompt you to say, are you sure you want to do this? Because it could run for a little bit long. Say yes, right? And it did also say run it once a week. The maximum you should do is once a day and not more. If I check on the history, you can see it's busy running, right? So while that is on the go, if at any time you want to check if there's any extra requests that can be added or removed, you can click on that button. If there's anything left here, you can bring it over, okay? Let's have a look, see, there we go. It's successful and there was a size, that means it completed. And running reports, of course, if you go to the scope, select storage, it is a type of disk storage, there's your data domain. And as always, because I've just defined it into DPA now, it collects the data from now onwards. It's not possible to go back and collect historical information because the DD simply does not have it. Right, does not store it. If we can run a host configuration report, for example, and this will tell me that it is a DDOS 7.2 system, right? DDVE version 5.0. That's how you check host. If you want to look at other attributes of it, for example, configuration, you can look at NTP configuration, maybe. Nothing has been defined. I don't think there is entry quota. It is, there it is. Okay. And of course, under performance, resource utilization, there's a whole bunch of reports here as well that you can have a look at. For example, the boost statistics. Not that there is any right now. the data domain client deduplication ratio report. Nothing right now, it's a lab system, so there's very little data here. But you get the general idea. Okay. Thank you. Enjoy. Hi, as an extra addendum to what I just said, I'd also like to clarify that when you collect data from a data domain, data collection, and specifically about the data domain analysis request, if I edit this request, you will see that it requires a credential and as possibly an extra security credential as well, right? So the credential you need to use does need to be a data domain admin role credential. Okay. And the security credential is used when the security officer 2FA type authentication has been enabled on your data domain. So when the agent goes and tries to go into SE mode to do the SFS dump, the data domain, if multi-factor authentication is enabled, will prompt for a security officer password, and that's the second one here. Okay. If the data domain is not using multi-factor authentication or 2FA or MFA, whatever, such like, then all you need is an admin role username. How did I check? How did we check? If you go into the history here, you'll be able to see that using an admin account from the messages, everything goes through quite smoothly, right? If I used a security officer only account, for example, or a deep data domain username that only has user privileges, you will see this error. This command is not available for this user. Right, so you do need an admin role data domain credential to enable or use the data domain analysis request.